That's what I like about Tamagotchi. Knew exactly where he was in the ring, went right to the ropes causing the break.
That is very smart of
Tamagotchi. Dictating the pace of the match right now, ever since the beginning, before the match even started.
Aaron Bradley trapped toehold.
Aaron Bradley using the costume, obviously, for leverage right now. He's got a handful of tights. The referee not saying anything about that. And I'm wondering why David Stone has some kind of bias towards Tamagotchi.
I think David Stone is doing a fairly good job of calling the
He's doing a great
right
job of calling
middle.
The match for the game changer right now.
Well, I think he's calling it down the middle, Paul.
Down the middle to the side of the game changer. Look at that picture. Perfect headlock right now.
But Aaron Bradley counters.
I think I see Aaron Bradley grabbing the fingers, though, being a little bit sneaky right there.
Now Aaron Bradley with that picture-perfect headlock.
I don't think David Stone should be checking to see if he's actually got a headlock or if he's holding onto that outfit for some support. Oh, look at Tamagotchi. Look at that. Picture perfect head scissors. Broke the headlock right into a head scissors. Tamagotchi is putting his hands up for defense, blocking any kind of offense the game changer can throw at him.
But now Aaron Bradley with that headlock.
And David Stone not even checking to see if that's a chokehold right now on the complete opposite side of the ring, trying to get the win for the game changer.
David Stone's doing a great job.
Look at that. Shot right to the face. Breaks the hold. Sends him into the ropes. Tamagotchi.
Oh, shoulder tackle.
Tamagotchi letting that shoulder tackle happen. Letting the game changer get a little confident.
And
holding on to the mask for leverage. Why isn't David Stone calling something like that? I don't know. But just keep your eyes on Tamagotchi. The man's a seasoned veteran. What we don't know about him, we do know that he's been at the Sanctuary Stunt Studio a long time.
Well, if you don't keep your eyes on Tamagotchi, you'll definitely...
Look at how fast he gets right back up. Breaks the momentum of the game changer right there. Smart, smart
stunt
fighting.
Oh, but Aaron Bradley, too smart for Tamagotchi.
Tamagotchi's still fresh in this match, though.
Nice by Aaron Bradley.
Yeah, definitely not bad. Not the perfect suplex in the world, but it got the job done for right now.
And the Sanctuary congregation behind the game changer.
And Tamagotchi wisely rolling to the outside of the ring, getting himself some air, trying to figure out what to do.
But Aaron Bradley looks like he's going for, it looked like a suicide dive, maybe.
Look at Tamagotchi, threw him right off of his game.
Yeah.
Now, why David Stone isn't counting to 10, I don't know, Brandy. This should be a 1, 2, 3. This is a count-out situation right here. David Stone obviously showing impartiality to the game changer because he wants him to win.
Well, he certainly hasn't started the count yet, but Aaron
Poor
Bradley.
Poor Tamagotchi flies in every week from Yokohama, Japan, and has to face this kind of bias because the Sanctuary congregation just does not want to see him pick up a win.
Well, I give it up to Tamagotchi, showing his dedication and his loyalty here to the congregation. I give him that.
He flies in every week from Tokyo. He should get a fair shake. Look at Tamagotchi right now, picking him apart right now.
Just taking it to the game changer.
That chop right to the shoulder blade. That could take his arm right out. If you don't have two arms in a fight, that's going to cost you, especially in a place like the Sanctuary. And right now, the game changer's in a world of hurt.
Right about that one.
I almost felt that kick from Tamagotchi. Solid kick right to the side.
And
why is it David Stone counting? This should be a victory right now for Tamagotchi. David Stone should stop the match. Game changer obviously is too hurt to get up right now.
Referee David Stone at a 3 count. Now a 4 count for Aaron Bradley.
Tamagotchi know he has the match won. He's just sitting back taking a break right now.
Can Aaron Bradley make it in before the count of 10? And Tamagotchi is just relaxing
Aaron
on the
Bradley's
top rope
in rough
over
shape
there.
Right now. And David Stone with a slow count, letting the game changer roll back into the ring. And Tamagotchi unloading on him right now. The frustration that's got to be building up in him right now. But he's keeping his cool. He's channeling that anger, and he's trying to hurt the game changer. Here comes a textbook suplex.
Nice suplex by Tamagotchi.
Nice and solid. Goes right into the cover. 1, 2. Should have been a 3 count. I don't know how the game changer kicked out, but he did. And Tamagotchi right back to work. This guy's got so many ways to beat you. It doesn't even matter that he didn't get that pinfall.
And Tamagotchi just taking it to Adam.
You know, I brought in a book of wrestling finishing holds for the guy that owns this place, John Trosky. I think Tamagotchi has even more moves than that book I brought in.
He probably does. I mean, as you said earlier, he's mysterious and very unpredictable.
The ropes.
And now Aaron Bradley.
Tamagotchi slipping on the ring mat, slipping down.
Oh, that kick to
gets
the
his
gut.
Momentum right back with a kick to the sternum.
Oh, and a DDT.
Perfect DDT. That's what I like about this guy. He can mix it up. He has the Japanese wrestling. He's got the American wrestling. I'm sure if he's pushed, he can even go into that Lucha Libre style where he jumps off the top
and
rope.
Aaron Bradley surprisingly kicks out at two after that DDT.
Aaron Bradley's hurting right now. Though, look at him. He's got no gas left in the tank.
Don't count out the Game Changer yet.
Tamagotchi with that excellent chin lock sunk right in, just wearing him down, cutting off the air supply. I don't care what good shape you're in. If you're not able to breathe, you're not able to fight. Right now, Tamagotchi is doing exactly what he has to.
Slams him down to the mat.
Tamagotchi got one. What's he going to do here?
It looks like Tamagotchi's going
for a figure four leg lock.
Oh, but Tamagotchi just got rammed into that steel ring post with shoulder.
But I thought I saw him get his hand up. Did he get all of that impact? I'm not really sure.
Maybe
think he's just playing possum right now, letting the Game Changer in a false sense of security. And David Stone not admonishing the count in the corner here. And look at Tamagotchi, just like that, switches the pace of the match.
Tamagotchi misses.
Tamagotchi missed, but right back on top of him. Picked up right on that mistake and got right back on top.
Yes, he is, Paul.
This is the kind of action I love coming to the Sanctuary Stunt Studio for. You have guys like Tamagotchi that know what they're doing in that ring. They're so scientific and precise with what they do.
I agree with you 1,000% on that
Tamagotchi
one.
Tamagotchi going to do here?
Nice by Aaron Bradley. And a
Tamagotchi
two
kicks
count
out.
By Tamagotchi. Neither man can get kept down.
Guy like Tamagotchi, you can't expect him to get down after a suplex. You got to keep taking the fight to him. You got to chop him down.
We got to give it up to Aaron Bradley. He's been hanging strong in this stunt fight also.
Aaron Bradley hung in last week at Jamie Senegal too. The guy's definitely a game changer for sure. But he's got to start getting more experience against guys like this to make himself better. I'm pretty sure I saw a punch thrown in there. The guy has to cheat to win, unfortunately. He's got to learn his craft a little bit better.
But that clothesline and a drop kick. And another drop kick. Aaron Bradley getting fired up here.
Oh, he throws a great drop kick for sure, but does he really have to resort to stuff like punching him in the face?
Here he comes.
Tamagotchi shoves him right off. Tamagotchi with a shot to the face. And Tamagotchi, what's he going to do? He's signaling for the end. This could be it. This could be it.
Oh.
Brainbuster.
Wonder who. Now, referee David Stone with the double count.
Both guys got the bad end of that brainbuster right there.
Here comes Tamagotchi. Aaron Bradley counters.
I think both men got the worst of that exchange.
Elbows to the temple.
There's a blatant knee right to the face. I mean, I don't really see how that's fair wrestling. Look at that, putting his hand through the ropes. And the game's
over. The winner by pinfall, the Game Changer, Aaron Bradley.
I'll definitely give credit where it's due. Aaron Bradley had to pull out that win any way he can.
Yes, you got to give it up to Aaron Bradley. He hung in tough.
But a guy like Tamagotchi is going to push you that far. This kid's got a bright future. If he tags up with someone like Jason King in here, there's no telling what he could do.
I agree with you. I agree with you 1,000%. But Aaron Bradley is walking out of here with the win here tonight.
Last week, Jamie Senegal. This week, Tamagotchi, Motorola. Who's he going to face next week?
The following stunt fight is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Poconos, weighing in at 240 pounds, Jason King.
Tony, last week this man proving he's the most dangerous man in the Sanctuary Stunt Studio put out Ryan Zero. And then we all saw what he did to Angus Bradford last week as well. This
you know,
man
Paul,
doing whatever it takes to win because this man has his sights set on dominating the Sanctuary.
You know, Paul, I have to say, Jason King has proven week after week why he's one of the most dangerous stunt fighters here at the congregation. I mean, he wreaks havoc on any opponent he faces.
Jason King is all about destruction. I mean, he's all about slash and burn. Wherever he comes in, he doesn't care about getting a win. He wants to leave a mark, and he left a mark last week.
Yes, he did.
And he's here to do it tonight, too. And there we see with him Jamie Senegal and the lovely Bree Lane coming out to the ring with him as well.
Along with Bree Lane and Jamie Senegal.
I have so much respect for a guy like Jason King, and I'll tell you why after you announce the next guy for the match.
And his opponent from Newark, New Jersey, weighing in at 290 pounds, the most diligent man alive, Corey Dillinger.
Well, this is our first look at Corey Dillinger. I'm really anxious to see what this guy looks like.
Corey Dillinger, my God,
he's huge.
Corey Dillinger making his Sanctuary Stunt Studio debut here tonight.
He's going to not take anything away from Jason King. The man knows what he's doing in that ring. Now look at the guy like Corey Dillinger coming down here.
He's a big one, that's for sure.
A big one in all attitude, too. You can tell this guy's tough. Jason King's going to really have to bring it tonight. But he's going to, because
yes,
he does it every single week.
Yes, he does. And in spite of the size, if I was Corey Dillinger, I'd be a little hesitant to step in here with Jason King.
If I was Corey Dillinger, I'd be making sure I keep my eyes on everything Jason King's going to throw at him.
This
man's definitely big and strong, but Jason King, definitely the experience advantage. And Jason King is vicious.
And with Jamie Senegal and Bree Lane by his side, he definitely has to have eyes on the
exactly
back of
his
head.
I was talking about before. He surrounds himself with a beautiful lady and an amazing athlete like Jamie Senegal. That's why I like Jason King. The man does what every successful person does. He gets success and he surrounds himself with people that understand him.
And this stunt fight is underway.
I just cannot get over how big this Corey Dillinger is.
As Corey Dillinger takes on the dangerous Jason King.
See, if I was Jason, I'd be doing exactly that. He's getting in the ropes right now, getting a break. You have to size a guy like this up, because if you take a guy like this for granted, you're on your back 1, 2, 3. I don't think Jason's intimidated or scared, but Jason is thinking to himself, I have to pull something out to beat a guy this big.
But, Paul, you do have to take in account that Corey Dillinger has the guts to take on someone like Jason King.
Absolutely. If I was the size and intimidating and look like Corey Dillinger, I'd want to fight anybody. Corey Dillinger causing a little bit of separation right now.
Corey Dillinger with that aggressive...
And you have to watch a guy like Corey Dillinger. I wish the referee Popeye would look a little more closely at him. Because a guy like that big could rip Jason's arm right out of the mat. That's not even stunt fighting. You know, that's just being dangerous. I don't know why the referee... Look at that slam. The referee not keeping an eye on Corey Dillinger and telling him to watch. This is a stunt fight.
And Jamie Senegal checking on Jason King.
Jason King coming outside right now. Just getting himself a little bit of air. He's got to regroup here. That was a hard slam. That knocked the air out of him for sure.
Yeah, that definitely did not
tickle. Look at Jason King coming in right there, capitalizing right on that.
And Jamie
How could
Senegal,
you take your eyes off of Jason King like he just did?
Jamie Senegal with that distraction.
That was one.
Oh, huge shoulder tackle to Jason King. And Jamie Senegal is not happy about it.
But look at Jason King. He just got ran over by a truck, and he's getting right back up.
He blocked the hip toss. Oh, but Corey Dillinger with that huge clothesline.
I think I saw Corey Dillinger pulling on Jason King's singlet to give himself a little bit of leverage.
Nice slam.
The referee really not paying attention to the moves that Corey Dillinger is doing right now.
And the congregation is loving what they see here. But Jamie Senegal is on a mat.
Jamie Senegal showing concern for Jason King right now.
And of course the distraction.
And Jason King right to the knee. That's exactly what you have to do against a guy this big. Take him down.
Oh, sidewall slam.
Look at how big that guy's legs are. If you take the legs out, that's half of his arsenal right there. Jason King, not only is he dangerous, he's smart. Cut him off right at the knees, and now just staying on top of him.
Jason King, the veteran here.
You have to wear a guy this big down. He's obviously not going to go down easy. You have to chop him down like that big tree that he is. But once he's down, Jason knows exactly what to do.
Jason King with the knees to the knee.
A knee right to the back of the leg. That is one of the most painful things you'll ever feel. That's going to cramp up that leg. That's going to Charlie horse up that calf. He's not going to be able to get up.
Well, it'll definitely keep him off his feet. That's for sure.
Jason King just showing everybody why he dominates in the sanctuary.
Oh, but Corey Dillinger looks like he's got some fight left in him as he hammers away at Jason King.
Oh, look at that bad wheel. Jason King right back to the leg.
And a DDT.
This could be it. This could be it right now. Two.
Oh, but Corey Dillinger surprisingly kicks out, Paul.
I think he was counting with his bad eye. He did not. That should have been a three count.
Now, Paul, what do you think about that? What do you think about
Corey? I think he has terrible peripheral vision, the referee.
Well.
Right now, Corey Dillinger being stretched by Jason King. When you stretch a guy's arm that way, he's not going to be able to breathe. If a guy that big's not able to breathe, he can't get energy. Without energy, he's dead in the water right now. Look at Jason King right on top. Knee right to the head. Look at Bree Lane checking on him, and Jason Senegal, too. They're not bad people. They were checking on him to see how he's doing. They know he's a first-timer here.
Paul, I beg to differ. I do not think they were checking on Corey Dillinger.
It's just the kind of people they are. You may think they have attitude, but look at that. Went over right there to check on him. I have to respect that about the entire Devil's Rejects.
Paul, we're watching the same match, the same stunt fights here. I think we all know what we saw.
I think we saw a great show of sportsmanship from not only Jamie Senegal, but from Bree Lane. Look at her cheering on her man. That's loyalty right there.
Well, of course she is.
And look at that leg drop by Jason King. Look at that leg drop.
And Corey Dillinger still kicking out. I admire Corey Dillinger.
Corey Dillinger's definitely got a lot of fight. He's definitely got a lot of fight in him for sure, but look at Jason King, like I said, wearing him down. He's chopping him down. That's exactly what you should do.
Here comes Jason off of that second rope. Oh, but he misses.
Jason King slipping off of the second rope.
Jason King missing.
I think we should really check those ropes out. I think I saw him slip.
No, he did not slip.
Jason King slipping off of the second rope and landing right on his lower back.
No. Corey Dillinger.
Look at Jason King getting up. He's fighting to get up right now.
He has some life left in him.
Jason King's got a ton of heart. Look at that shot right to the face. Rocked him. Why is the referee letting Dillinger punch like that? That's an open fist. Jason King with a shot right to the face. Why is he letting him punch?
He's calling this match right down the middle here. Here comes Corey. Corey Dillinger with the series of right.
This isn't a boxing match. He should be using an open fist.
Corey Dillinger firing up.
Corey Dillinger unloading for sure, but look at Jason King. He's still in this. He's still in this. He's getting up.
Oh, and he just got rammed into the turnbuckle.
I'm not really clear on stunt fighting rules. Are you allowed to use the corner and the turnbuckles as a weapon? I'm not so sure.
Oh, but Corey.
Corey with a shot from behind. Come on.
But now here comes Jamie trying to distract.
Why are we not seeing any sportsmanship? That was a clothesline from behind.
Jason kicks at it too.
And Jamie Senegal feels the same way I do. Look at that, telling the referee, hit him from behind.
Well, of course you would. agree with Jamie.
I think what the referee should do right now is get some order in this match, because right now I think he's starting to lose that. Jason King right from behind, taking full advantage. Look at that chop.
Oh, nice. By
Corey Dillinger. Jason King just get choked. Since when are we allowed to choke in the Sanctuary Stunt Studio?
Oh, but
Jamie Senegal concerned again.
I don't think he's showing concern.
What an unselfish human being he is. Checking on Dillinger, checking on Jason King.
And Jamie again trying to distract, but Corey Dillinger has him a handful of Jamie.
Jamie Senegal's not even involved in this match. Why is he throwing him into the ring?
Because he keeps butting in, Paul.
Jamie Senegal's not a part of this match. He's got to work tonight later.
Well, Jamie Senegal kept butting in, and now Jamie Senegal is paying.
But whoever Jamie Senegal's wrestling tonight, they're going to have the advantage. I hope that that referee is not going to be the referee for the final fight tonight.
And
referee not facing on Jamie Senegal.
And now you got Bree Lane interfering.
I didn't see anything. I saw Jason King take advantage right now. And right now, Jason King with the win. Jason King just went through hell and back, but this week, again, for the last 3 months, just keeps winning and winning and winning.
Well, you gotta admit, he's had a lot of help from his family.
He's got a lot of luck on his side. Whenever I go outside to shoot dice when I go to the casino to play games, I'm gonna take Jason King with me because I know I'm gonna come out a winner every time.
Oh, well, you call it luck. I call it something else.
And three-fourths of the Devil's Rejects in the ring right now.
Jason King, victorious here tonight at the Stunt Studio. And unfortunately for Corey Dillinger, on his debut stunt fight.
Corey Dillinger is definitely going to be back, and he learned a lesson tonight by stunt fighting one of the best. He learned what it's going to have to take to stay alive here in the Sanctuary. Corey Dillinger, do not take anything away from him. Hard-fought match, but Jason King showing what a great athlete he is and pulled out the win. I'm worried about Jason Senegal tonight. I think that body slam earlier is definitely going to affect his match later tonight.
Well, he shouldn't have butted in, Paul. If he had not butted in, he wouldn't have it.
The man cares about a lot of people.
The following stunt fight is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing in at 225 pounds, Mr. All Day, Kenny Bangle.
Kenny
Bangle about to make his way to the ring. Was here last week as well. This guy's another athlete to watch.
Yes, he is. Great athlete,
Mr. Bangle. Amazing physical specimen coming down the aisle right now.
Kenny Bangle, so confident, so sure of himself.
When you're an athlete of that caliber, you can be that sure of yourself, and you can be that confident. Because you know at any time you can get the win.
I give it up to Kenny Bangle. He's extraordinary.
Look at him taking his time getting down to the ring, too. Soaking in that spotlight right now.
And his opponent from Jersey City, weighing in at 195 pounds, the Concrete Rose, Sonny Kiss.
Sonny Kiss. Making his way down to the Stunt Studio ring.
Sonny Kiss and Kenny Bangle. I've got one word to describe this match: athletics.
What's that? Yes, I agree, 1,000%.
Both of these men, phenomenal athletes, not even hitting their prime yet. They're going to tear this house down.
Yes, they are. Sonny Kiss.
I first saw Sonny Kiss wrestle last year, and I knew from the beginning when this guy got to the sanctuary, he was going to be something.
Yes.
But tonight, look at who he's up against. Look at Kenny Bangle right now. All business on his face right now. Kenny Bangle's here to fight, and he's going to take it to Sonny Kiss.
Sonny Kiss, so athletic, so agile.
Definitely amazing flexibility, amazing strength in those legs. Is that going to be enough to beat Kenny Bangle? We're definitely going to see.
We shall see.
Kenny Bangle, energetic. He's ready to go. Sonny Kiss, same thing. Men, I'd say definitely evenly matched. I think the winner is going to be the one that just fights a little bit harder tonight.
I agree with you.
I do know this. Everyone here in the sanctuary and watching on YouTube is in for a treat. This is going to be one hell of a stunt fight.
This is going to be a great stunt fight.
Look at Sonny Kiss. Once the music stops, he's all business when he's in that ring. But he's got to be all business against Kenny Bangle, too. There's a reason why they call him Mr. All Night.
All day.
Same thing. This guy can just go and go and go all day, all night, all week.
Tomato, tomato.
Showing Sonny that he's just as flexible and powerful in those legs.
Well, the athleticism is just about equal here. As referee David Stone.
Kenny Bangle, maybe have a little size advantage. We'll see if he knows how to use that against Sonny Kiss. One thing you cannot do against Sonny is make a mistake. So we're going to see what Kenny Bangle can do tonight.
Sonny Kiss.
Sonny getting right into his face, too. Not even intimidated.
And Kenny Bangle is not liking what the sanctuary congregation.
If you're a guy like Kenny Bangle, you don't like people bowing up to you like that because that means they're not afraid of you. Look at that, shoving him right in the face.
And Sonny Kiss.
Sonny Kiss with blatant punches right to the face.
Right forearms, and Sonny Kiss loose best press.
And David Stone again letting this kind of mugging happen. Why they just can't keep it in the confines of the ring, keep it a competitive match, I don't know. Slipping on the mat right now.
Sonny Kiss taking it to Kenny Bangle, showing his
taking advantage of Kenny Bangle slipping on that mat.
And on one count.
Rest assured, if he didn't fall like that, this complexity of this match would have changed already. And look at that reversal right into the corner. Kenny Bangle mounting his comeback right now.
Oh, but Sonny Kiss with that kick.
I think a kick caught him right in the eye.
Oh, but Kenny Bangle just throws Sonny Kiss down to the mat.
As David Stone, I'd call it right now. Kenny, Sonny Kiss is not in the eight.
And
not
now
able
Kenny
to compete
Bangle
right
in
now.
Control.
That was all impact to the small of the back.
And the congregation is solely behind Sonny Kiss.
Sonny Kiss could have all the congregation he wants for that concussion right now. That's not really going to help him. He needs a bag of ice.
Well, Sonny, he's tough. He's a tough competitor.
Tough right now, but right now Kenny Bangle taking the fight right to him. Look at that slam right into the turnbuckle pad. Took him right down. Kenny Bangle just basking in his domination right now. Kenny Bangle showing why he's Mr. All Night and All Day. Snapmare takes Sonny Kiss right down.
Oh, but Kenny Bangle just with that kick to Sonny Kiss.
Kenny Bangle keeping it smart right now. Instead of spending a lot of energy trying to, try to outmaneuver Sonny Kiss, just hitting him with really high impact moves. That's going to wear him down, and he's also going to save a lot of energy doing it. Smart stunt fighting right there.
Kenny Bangle is definitely in control of this stunt fight.
By the way, if you take away an arm like that, a one-armed guy in an ass-kicking contest is not going to be helpful.
Well, this is true.
Sonny Kiss violently getting up, but what's waiting for him getting up right now?
Oh, here comes Sonny. Two count. Oh, and a
look
huge
at that.
Clothesline.
Wrapped him up.
Almost taking the head off of Sonny Kiss.
Kenny Bangle wrapping Sonny Kiss right up. I think the match should be stopped right now. Sonny Kiss is out. This is it. It's all academic. One, two, three.
Oh, but obviously he's not, Paul. He kicked out at two.
How did David Stone not kick out on three on that? If I got hit like that, I would still be down till next week.
That just goes to show you what kind of competitor Sonny Kiss is. He's tough. He hangs in there. He does not give up.
He can hang in there all he wants. That's just going to give Kenny Bengal more time to wear him down.
I'm sure Kenny Bengal is just enjoying putting his punishment on Sonny.
Kenny Bengal taking a breather right now, just kind of relaxing on the ropes. I don't know why David Stone's giving him such a hard time.
Well, he's doing his job, Paul.
Frustrated enough and kicking the rope, too. This is just such impartial officiating right now. I just can't believe this goes on.
Well, I believe David Stone is calling it right down the middle. He's doing a great job at officiating this match. Stunt fight.
Letting Sonny Kiss get away with those punches right to the face. Those should be open hand shots or palm shots, not with a closed fist.
Those look like elbows or forearms to me, Paul.
Make no mistake, Kenny Bengal still knows what he's doing in that ring right now. He's going to mount a comeback any minute, and when he does, Sonny Kiss is going to be in more trouble than he was before. Look at that reversal right into the turnbuckle.
Oh, but Kenny Bengal.
Kenny Bengal using the ropes for advantage.
Sonny Kiss.
Sonny Kiss using the ropes for his advantage right there.
Here comes Sonny.
And Kenny Bengal still kicking out. Still kicking out.
And another cover. Oh, nice unique cover by Sonny Kiss.
Don't even call that a cover. He was not on top of the man, not covering the shoulders.
But his shoulders were down. Kenny Bengal's shoulders were down.
Sonny Kiss is not on top of it. David, speaking of not being on top, David Stone not being on top of his game right now.
I don't know. Well, Sonny Kiss is.
Sonny Kiss not giving up. He's determined to hit that monkey flip, and he does. That's a lot of impact to the back. But look at that right back up with a super kick.
That kick was right on the button for Sonny Kiss.
Either ring that bell or he just got that bell rung.
Sonny Kiss
is out. Here comes one, two, three.
Oh, but surprisingly, he kicks out.
David Stone again.
The concrete rose kicks
with the slow count.
A devastating kick to the side of the head.
Right now, the concrete rose is getting hit with a jackhammer. But that jackhammer's name is Kenny Bengal.
Kenny Bengal looking for that three.
Kenny Bengal is taking his time. He knows he could beat this, end this stunt fight anytime he wants to. I'm really enjoying watching this guy every week, because every week he impresses me more and more.
Well, Sonny Kiss, he's also very impressive.
Sonny Kiss hanging in there, but right now, how much more punishment like this can you take?
This is
a man constantly beating you down.
Well, Sonny Kiss is not a quitter.
You might not be a quitter, but it's always a good time to give up when you know you're not going to win.
Count the man out yet.
Here we
Paul.
Go. One, two, three. Ring the bell.
That was a two count, Paul.
Just hear it. Ring referee. The bell. Ring the bell. This is it.
Referee David Stone said so.
David Stone right now just completely. I think I should be the referee from now on.
Oh, really?
We got David Stone not counting fast enough. We have a referee with only one good eye.
I think you're fine right up here with me, Paul.
I think so, too. I'm glad that I'm able to actually, brighten up your Friday night.
Thank you, Paul. I really appreciate it. And both men are down.
Men are down right now, but look at Kenny Bengal starting to get up.
And so is Sonny.
Showing signs of life.
So is Sonny.
Do you want a guy like Kenny Bengal showing signs of life and getting himself hyped up again after you've been taking such a beating all night? Sonny Kiss on the ropes right there. That should be it right there. He's given up. That's it.
Referee at seven.
Do you have a towel? I feel like I should throw it in for him.
No. Absolutely not. This is not over. And Sonny Kiss. Baseball slide. Nice.
Kenny Bengal right back up after the drop
Sonny
kick.
Kiss starting
and the
to fire
elbow
up.
Drop. Kenny Bengal mounting his comeback right now. He's going to do something. Just wait and see. Here it comes. Yeah, Kenny Bengal, look at that.
Oh, nice by the concrete rose.
If I was David Stone, I'd be definitely checking on Kenny Bengal right now because I think he's got a few broken teeth.
I think think Kenny Bangle's just fine.
I think out of compassion to Kenny Bangle after getting his jaw broken, they should award the match to him and stop it immediately.
Even Sonny Kiss thought that may have been a three count. But David Stone calling his right down
David
the
Stone
middle.
David Stone showing more interest in how Sonny Kiss is doing than Kenny Bangle.
And Sonny Kiss getting frustrated here, but
and
he cannot
Kenny
get frustrated
And Kenny Bangle giving
right
it
now.
Right back to Sonny Kiss, dropping him on his jaw.
Oh, but Sonny Kiss, he counters. Went for the roundhouse kick.
Solid shot right to the abdomen. Here it comes.
Here it comes. Oh, but Sonny Kiss counters again. Here he comes.
Sonny Kiss wasting too much time. Wasting too much time.
Oh, nice. By the concrete roll, Sonny Kiss. Now he should go for the cover, Paul.
Why David Stone lets Sonny Kiss use the ring ropes for leverage is just showing me that he just does not know what he's doing in that ring as a referee. And look at that. Kenny Bangle again kicking out. What does Sonny Kiss have to do to put this man down?
I am shocked that Kenny Bangle kicked out after that devastating maneuver. And obviously, Sonny Kiss is just as surprised.
Sonny Kiss getting frustrated right now. What does he have to do? He's throwing everything he has at this man, and he keeps getting
Sonny
up.
Sonny Kiss, he's going to have to dig down deep and think of something to keep the big
man
down.
Sonny Kiss well is starting to run dry. He doesn't have any far deeper to dig.
Oh, that
solid shot right to the head. Knocks him for a loop again. Kenny Bangle getting up, measuring Sonny Kiss.
Oh, here comes with the athleticism.
Sonny Kiss holding onto the ropes. I don't know the referee's not stopping that. Sonny Kiss just not fighting fair, trying to pull the man off the ropes.
And here comes Kenny Bangle.
Sonny Kiss disoriented for some reason. I don't know how that happened, but right now Kenny Bangle
spikes
him with the DDT.
Sonny Kiss.
I don't know how someone could fold up like that about being dropped on their head. I think we should
that
really stop this and get a doctor.
It.
This has to be it. Kenny Bangle definitely pulling out all the stops, but I mean, look at Sonny Kiss right now, Brandy.
Kenny Bangle with that devastating DDT, and Sonny Kiss
Sonny's not moving. I have never seen anyone get impacted on their head and then fold up like that.
I agree, Paul.
As much as I don't agree with how he works, they should definitely go and check on Sonny Kiss right now. He's not moving.
And Sonny Kiss is not moving.
Even I feel bad for Sonny Kiss right now. Clutching at his head too. He might have some really severe neck trauma going into that. That was all whiplash.
Man. Sonny Kiss barely moving right now.
Kiss
but
is down and he's hurt.
Kenny Bangle walks away with the W here tonight.
Look at how focused he stays. As the referee put the jacket back on him, you know, he is the winner.
Yeah.
The focus should be on Kenny Bangle for winning this match for sure. But I feel bad for Sonny Kiss. Right now, Kenny Bangle walking back to the aisle, walking back to the locker room, the victor tonight.
With his vest back on.
With his vest back on, he earned it. Sonny Kiss definitely a valiant effort, but look at the victor tonight, Kenny Bangle. Referee's still checking on Sonny Kiss right now. Surprised he's even getting up right now. Sonny! I'll definitely give Sonny credit for walking out of there. A guy got dropped right on
definitely.
The top of his head.
And Sonny Kiss spaghetti leg, as they say.
At least he made it back to the locker room. I think we could all applaud him for that.
Yes, he did. I'm glad he's walking out of here tonight.
Lucky enough to be walking out on his own.
You're right about that one, being dropped on your head.
Dropped on your head and so hard, too.
Yes. And Sanctuary Congregation, as we get ready for our main event here tonight.
Definitely stunned by all the matches they've seen tonight. They've definitely seen some great stunt fighting
tonight.
Yes,
we did. Great competitors, great stunt fighters.
I think that's why everyone comes up here every week. You know, we had some amazing athletes in
here.
Yes,
we do. Absolutely. They all train hard.
Tamagotchi Motorola, I understand, is going back to the airport, flying back to Japan. Who knows when he's going to be back? And quite frankly, I'm kind of nervous about that because I never know when the guy's going to show up.
This is true.
And we got the referee Popeye back in here. We're going to see how impartial this next match is going to be.
Oh.
I'm sorry, stunt fight.
Yes, stunt fights.
I have never ever heard of a one-eyed referee.
All right, Hazleton, Pennsylvania. It is now time for your Sanctuary Stunt Studio main event.
And we all know who this is, Paul.
Can you believe Jamie Senegal, after taking that body slam earlier tonight, is coming out to the ring, ready to fight?
Absolutely, I know. I'm surprised he's still walking.
Still walking, and look at him. He's not letting it affect him right now. Is that going to play a part in the fight tonight? We're definitely going to have to see.
We shall see, Paul. Being accompanied by Bree Lane.
Bree Lane, the lovely girlfriend of Jason King. And I just love seeing these guys come down the ring. It's this camaraderie right now.
Oh.
You know, Jason King telling his friends, go out there. I'll be watching you guys from the back if you need me. But you're not going to. Because when you're an athlete like Jamie Senegal, you don't need anyone watching your back. That's just Jason King saying, I'm here if you need it.
And as we wait for Jamie Senegal's opponent...
going to be our first look at Maria Manic, and honestly, I cannot wait to see what comes through that curtain right now.
Yes,
Jamie Senegal is definitely going to be ready, but getting slammed on his back earlier tonight. Look at him touching his back right now. That might still have a few kinks left in there, but we're going
to
see.
I'm actually excited to see Maria Manic here tonight. We've seen a lot of her on social media, wrestling around New Jersey and Pennsylvania.
Well, those Jersey girls definitely know how to fight, so I hope she brings her A-game tonight, because against a guy like Jamie Senegal,
yes,
not only an athlete, not only friends with Jason King, he knows what he's doing
and
in that
here
ring.
She is, Maria Manic.
Jamie Senegal definitely not happy with what just came through the curtain right now. Not that he's the jealous type. I just don't think he wants someone coming in here stealing his spotlight, which is what Maria Manic is attempting to do right now.
Jamie Senegal does not look impressed.
Jamie Senegal does not look intimidated either. He is not going to let this woman get into his head.
Introducing first.
Get the referee not even holding the ropes the right way for an athlete like Jamie Senegal.
Lane! She brings to the ring tonight, weighing 174 pounds. From Rehoboth Beach, Delaware, representing the Devil's Rejects, Jamie Senegal!
Jamie Senegal, absolutely right. For the last 3 months, the Devil's Rejects just keep winning, winning, and winning.
His opponent,
right about
last
that.
Week,
from
a clean
Malibu,
sweep.
California, Maria Manic!
Maria Manic making her Sanctuary debut here.
Flying all the way in from California, there's definitely going to be some jet lag here. Let's hope Jamie Senegal uses that to his advantage.
No.
Let's hear what he has to say.
I think Maria Manic is just
What's
fine.
Your name, Maria? Is that what it is? Maria. She's kind of pretty. For a crayon. Okay, Maria. I have a proposition for you. You can either come here, be the little Barbie you are, and help valet me because I'm a winner and we can rule the sanctuary, or I'll just kick your ass.
Jamie.
Saying all the very reasonable offer. If I was Maria Manic, I would definitely take
and
him up
Jamie,
on that.
What if I were to kick your ass?
Not gonna happen.
What would happen then?
I would not take Maria Manic lightly.
You think I'm scared of you?
Not taking
Jamie?
Her lightly at all, but remember who Jamie,
Jamie
Senegal
I know who
is.
You are. You obviously don't know.
All right, Maria, since you want to do this the hard way, Annie, I don't need you. This is an off night for me. I love you and everything you do, but as you can see, I'm working a plastic toy.
Oh, Jamie just threw the microphone at Maria Manic.
I think that's what the kids do these days. They symbolically drop the microphone. I think Maria Manic should have got out of the way. That was her fault that she got hit with that.
And Jamie Senegal dismissing Bree Lane, sending her to the back.
She needs to go sit with Jason Kidd. You know, she has to go check on him. He had a rough night tonight. Did you see that stunt fight he had?
He had quite a rough night.
And right now, Jenny Senegal is going to make an example out of this California Barbie doll that came out to the ring.
As I said, I would not take Maria Manic lightly.
I wouldn't take Maria Manic lightly at all, but Jamie Senegal's dangerous. He proves it every time he gets in that ring. And I don't think Maria Manic's ever been in the ring with someone like Jamie Senegal.
I don't know.
The crowd's solidly behind Jamie right now.
Well, one thing's for sure, they are both wearing pink here tonight.
But Jamie just wears it so much better, I think.
No, I think I like Maria's pink better.
Colors aside, I think Maria Manic's definitely going to be in for a fight tonight.
Reminds me so much of Barbie. You know, I used to play with a lot of Barbies when I was younger myself, so.
I used to run over my sister's Barbie dolls with the lawnmower, but I know exactly what you're saying. Barbie dolls are a lot of fun to play with. I think Jamie Senegal feels the exact same way I do, and he's going to prove it tonight.
We shall see how this goes down.
Jamie Senegal coming out of his shell, coming. Look at Jamie Senegal is ripping right into her. And Maria Manic not doing anything. I thought these California girls were all about attitude and being badass.
Right
now, not doing anything.
Don't count her out yet.
How did the referee let that happen? The match didn't even start. That is not winning an arm wrestling match. It's cheating.
That was not cheating, Paul.
Jamie Senegal may take the high road here and let her try to do it again. I think the referee should really keep an eye on what's going on. And not let this happen.
The referee's doing a fine job.
He's got one good eye and he's distracted by the girl in the pink right now. This is not working out for Jamie Senegal's advantage. It rarely ever does here.
And again, Maria Manic defeated Jamie Senegal in the arm wrestling contest.
This is not the World Arm Wrestling Championships. This is the Sanctuary Stunt Studio.
Well, Jamie called it. He said he challenged her to an arm wrestling match.
Jamie Senegal giving her the win because she flew all the way out from California. Just, you know, giving her a little something to go back with. Right now, Maria Manic just wasting a lot of time right now. Not taking the fight to Jamie Senegal. I think Maria Manic just showing a little bit of nerves right now, not knowing how to take a guy like Jamie Senegal, so she's kind of hiding out in the corner.
I doubt
right now
that she's nervous at all.
And Jamie Senegal looking for an old-fashioned Greco-Roman test of strength right now. Let's see, lock in. There's no getting out. Look at Jamie Senegal going right into the ropes. The referee not breaking it up right now. Look at Jamie Senegal dominating, not breaking it up.
Maria Manic and Jamie Senegal, a test of strength here. And Maria Manic.
Maria Manic pushing and using the ropes as an advantage to push Jamie Senegal down.
Showing her strength against Jamie Senegal.
Showing ring savvy using the ropes, but I wouldn't say strength because she had to push into the ropes to knock him down. Jamie Senegal is a strong kid.
I call it strength.
I saw her trip Jamie Senegal right there. Did you see that too?
I did not.
That's exactly what I saw.
She did not trip him.
This girl's coming into the sanctuary disrespecting Jamie Senegal. Jamie Senegal not
and
having
Jamie
it.
Jamie just pushing Maria
will
Manic.
Not
now
have that kind of disrespect
oh,
to this
Maria
house.
Oh, Maria Manic. Uh-oh, here she comes. Oh, with that kick to the head. And Maria Manic in control here now.
Maria Manic can't keep this as an even keel or an even fight.
Nice. Nice.
Has to fight dirty to beat a guy like Jamie
Senegal. Oh, nice clothesline. As Jamie Senegal rolls out to the outside of the ring.
Jamie Senegal doesn't know what to do right now because instead of this being a fair stunt fight, this girl's doing whatever she wants in the ring. No respect for the rules, no respect for sportsmanship right now. I've never seen the odds stack so much against Jamie Senegal in my life.
Here comes Maria. Maria
just getting caught up in the ropes just right there. That's just...
Jamie Senegal clearly took a shot at
Maria. I think
Jamie
was trying to prevent her from actually falling through the ropes because he still wants to keep this a stunt fight and keep sportsmanship in there. Hey, Jamie Senegal right now.
Oh!
Picture perfect suplex right on the floor.
Suplex right on the outside.
Ring the bell. This is over. This is it. Jamie Senegal with the win again.
Jamie Senegal proud of
his
actions.
Like he does every week. Like the Devil's Rejects do every single week. Look at Jamie Senegal go right now.
Oh, and Maria Manic.
I'm not really sure how fair it is to use a steel pole in a match.
Referee Eddie Powell with that count.
Maria Manic obviously not caring about the rules, not caring about being fair or sportsmanlike. Kicking a man while he's down. I think the referee should give Jamie a 30 count if he's going to try to get him into the ring. Give him a little bit of time.
30 count?
The guy smacked his head into a pole. He needs more time.
Maria Manic with those chops to the chest.
I think that woke Jamie Senegal up. He's focused right now. The last thing you want to do is piss him off.
Oh, but Jamie.
Jamie Senegal responds with a chop of his own.
Tries to roll her back into the ring.
Jamie Senegal being absolutely vicious right now.
And Maria.
Why is Maria trying to hit Jamie's head into the mat again?
Because he did the same to her, Paul. Favor for favor.
He was trying to help her in the ring. She kept slipping on the mats outside. Here comes top flight security running down the aisle. Jamie Senegal right now, obviously.
Nice kick by Maria Manic.
Working on a game plan right now, trying to get himself back up here. Jamie's sending off fighting
elbow.
Right back.
Oh, my. Jamie Senegal just drove Maria Manic to the side of the ring apron.
Not going to send her back to California, but it's going to send her up to the hospital after that. Jamie Senegal again, measuring her up for another chop. Listen to this.
Oh, a huge chop across the chest. Sanctuary congregation is behind Maria Manic.
Solidly behind Jamie Senegal right now. Look at Jamie just basking in the glow of the lights here because he knows he can win this match anytime he wants
to. I'm not hearing any chants for Jamie. I'm hearing a lot of Maria chants.
There's a lot of feedback in the congregation tonight. I'm definitely hearing some Jamie chants. And Maria pulling the tights on Jamie Senegal, trying to cheat and sneak a win in. Jamie Senegal not having any of it. Look at him getting right back up.
Maria coming back.
Maria should let him. All right, I'll respect that. Let him get up instead of kicking him like
he
was down
before. Oh, those forearms.
Maria with those solid punches to the face.
Oh, now small package.
And Jamie Senegal here trying to mount offense.
Oh, nice.
I think I definitely saw Maria Manic hold something. Oh, yeah, Jamie Senegal. Running knee.
It got her in the chin.
Jamie Senegal, just like that, changes the complexion of the whole match. Right now, choking Maria Manic in the corner, doing whatever it takes to win right now. I don't think Maria Manic knows what to do at the moment right now.
Maria Manic, she just has to collect her thoughts.
Probably saying to herself, why did I agree to fight Jamie Senegal tonight at the Sanctuary Stunt Studio?
I believe she will get back in the stunt fight.
She better start doing something quick because right now, all Jamie Senegal is doing is building momentum.
Oh, another huge chop.
You do not want somebody like Jamie Senegal building momentum. Senegal driving his shoulder right into the abdomen. tell you what, I think the referees should just stop this right out. This is just straight up brutality right now.
Here comes Maria. She's coming back. All right.
I don't see how Maria driving her shoulder into Jamie's abdomen like that is fair fighting, but what do I know? I'm not a Sanctuary Stunt Studio referee. I just don't know why it's allowed to happen. Pulling the hair to pull Jamie Senegal down.
Nice move by Maria Manic. And Maria Manic starting to get back in the stunt fight in a two count.
Disrespecting Jamie in his own house. And Jamie pushes her right back. And Jamie Senegal, that perfect enziguri kick. Maria Manic's down. She's out. The referee should be counting three right now.
But Jamie Senegal, he has.
Senegal taking a breather right now, taking a knee. You know, getting some air back into his system, he needs to do that.
That's a unique breather to take.
Absolutely, it is. He knows what he's
with
doing
in
there.
With someone's shin across their neck.
I'm not really sure I saw that from my vantage point right now.
Oh, really?
I did see Jamie just getting himself some air. In a physical contest like this, and he's hanging in there, too. He's taking a lot of abuse from this young lady. You do have to get your air sometimes. Speaking of getting air, watch Jamie do this.
Oh, both knees to the back.
That had to be at least a 6-foot vertical leap. Jamie just
Manic.
An amazing athlete. Every time he comes through those ropes.
Manic is struggling here.
Manic struggling for sure. Now look at Jamie taking another breather right now, getting stretching a little bit on the ropes.
Those don't look like breathers himself to me, up. Paul.
Jamie's smart. He knows what to do in the ring. He knows when to stretch, when to breathe. Jamie's sending her right into the ropes. What's he going to do here?
And Maria Manic. And she drops Jamie Senegal across her knee. Perhaps a desperation move almost.
Oh, desperation for sure, because in a normal stunt fight, you wouldn't drop a guy across your knee like that. That's her being desperate and wanting to cheat.
And she goes for the cover. And
a
two count.
Does this tell people from California that wrestle in New Jersey act? Do they have to cheat to win? Or can they just be honorable athletes like Jamie Senegal?
And Maria Manic.
Maria Manic with a high crotch there.
Oh, but Jamie rolls her up. Looks like he was going for a handful of tights there.
Jamie just trying to get himself some more advantage there.
Oh, really?
I think Jamie, you know, definitely understands leverage. You know, try to get that extra boost right there.
I'm sure.
And look at Jamie Senegal still coming out of this thing looking like a stud.
Maria
again with these solid punches to the face.
Oh.
And a running punch to the face of Jamie
Senegal.
She launches
out of that turnbuckle. Oh, nice.
You know, I could definitely applaud her athleticism, her courage to fight, but
definitely.
You know, ripping off Jamie, you know, blatantly ripping off Jamie's look coming in here,
very
coming into the sanctuary.
By Maria Manic.
Disrespecting him in his own house.
And a drop kick.
And Jamie's showing her you do not do that in Jamie Senegal or the Devil's Reject's house.
And Jamie Senegal with that kick.
And every one of Jamie Senegal's shots, drop kicks, kicks, they're all pinpoint with accuracy.
But you have to give it up for Maria, for her to be hanging in there the way that she is.
I think Maria should just give it up right now. She's very outmatched right now with Jamie Senegal.
She will give up. She would never give up.
And right now, Jamie Senegal showing everybody that he's able to put her away. And did you see that kick right to the face?
Yes, I did. And I'm surprised she's still standing right now.
She's not standing now. She's out. Jamie Senegal with the win. Here it comes. Ring the bell.
And a two count, Paul.
I don't know what the referee was thinking right there. I mean, I do not think that was a fair enough count, but Jamie Senegal, that's fine. He'll just keep pouring on the punishment right now. Jamie saying he was going to throw her out, and he did.
Just throwing Maria Manic outside of the ring.
Maria Manic being manhandled right now by Jamie Senegal. Look, she's trying to make her way to the back. She's had enough. She's done.
I doubt that. Oh, and
Jamie Senegal cutting her right off, saying, no, we're done. What I say, we're done.
Maria
I love watching
Manic
him wrestle.
Manic is just struggling in this stunt fight against Jamie
love
Senegal.
Love watching Jamie Senegal's stunt fight. He clowns everybody.
Maria Manic, she needs to find something to
Maria
get
Manic
back
better start
into
moving fast because Jamie Senegal's on the attack.
Oh.
Solid kick right to the back of the head.
How is she even standing right now?
I think right now the referee should employ what's called a standing 10 count. They do it in boxing. I'll tell you what's amazing to me is Jamie Senegal could take so much punishment earlier tonight and come back and fight like this.
Here comes Maria with those chops.
Why isn't the referee counting this out? This match should have ended already. They've been out for longer than 10.
Seven. Maria's back in the ring, but here comes Jamie.
Jamie Senegal fighting to come back in here. Look at the heart this kid has. I get so impressed every week I watch him.
As Maria gets hung up on those ropes.
Jamie slipping on the ring mat right there, falling to the outside.
Jamie was clearly outside of the ring.
Jamie slipping and falling. Maria just happened to have her head there. Definitely an unfortunate chain of events right now.
About that.
Look at Jamie getting right back up. If I was Maria, I'd start thinking of doing something quick because right now her chances of winning are getting slimmer and slimmer.
As you said it, she's being manhandled by
Jamie
Senegal.
With another vicious kick right to the side.
And Jamie is showing no mercy.
Senegal taking another breather in the corner.
Looks like a familiar move I've seen a thousand times before.
Jamie Senegal taking a breather? Absolutely. And look at this. One, two.
And another two count. That just goes to show you the resilience of Maria Manic. She will not give up.
What should have been a three count is just making this match. If the referee had any kind of compassion for Maria Manic, he would end the match right now.
I bet if he just ended the match, she'd be very upset. But here comes Maria.
Jamie
with
that stiff punch right to the face and a knee right to the stomach.
Knee to the gut. Now, how fair is that?
How fair is it to see Jamie get punched in the face with a closed fist?
Those are
and the referee's standing there doing nothing.
Oh, and Maria with that headbutt. But Jamie.
Headbutts can cause concussions. I do not know why she's allowed to do something like that.
Both stunt fighters had the same idea.
But Jamie had the better idea, and right now just eating up some time right now, regaining his composure on the mat. He's got till 10. He's going to be smart enough to take.
Count now.
Jamie's definitely going to take advantage of this 10 count. And why shouldn't he? He's in control of this match right now. He could pin Maria Manic anytime he wants.
Well, both competitors, they're struggling to get onto their feet.
Jamie Senegal wisely staying on all fours right now, keeping this mat-based, keeping it grounded. And another close fist punch from Maria Manic.
Series of back and forth forearms.
Back and forth, but Jamie is getting the better of the two of them right now.
Oh, Maria!
Did you see Jamie just slip on the mat again? Those wrestling shoes of his are probably worn out. No traction.
He did not slip.
Something like that.
I guarantee you that.
We've got to check that mat out. He just slipped. That changed the whole complexion of this match, and it's taking the advantage and putting it right on Maria Manic.
Here comes Maria. Oh, and a clothesline. Maria's firing up here.
Look at Jamie getting right back up. He's absorbing all this punishment right now.
Maria has the congregation behind her 100%.
Jamie Senegal with the congregation solidly behind him right now, wanting to see a win. And look at Jamie Senegal, has her in the corner, charges right in.
Maria with that kick.
Jamie Senegal thinking better of it and turning around from what I saw.
Here it comes, and a crossbody.
And Jamie kicks out on two. Even though the referee tried to count fast right there, count Jamie out, because he's got a bias against him, Jamie Senegal still kicking out. And the referee with the fast 10 count right now, trying to count Jamie Senegal out. We're using the ropes for advantage and leverage again.
Oh,
look at Jamie Senegal.
Answers
right back with a kick to the face.
Maria Manic is down on the mat.
Jamie Senegal,
Jamie
playing
Senegal
her for a
with that
fool.
Kick as he goes for the cover.
Jamie Senegal had her convinced that he was down and answered with a kick right to the face. And Jamie Senegal again going right for more punishment here. Watch this.
Oh, this is a
another
unique
abdominal stretch.
Hold.
J- Jamie Senegal was smart right now, he would start open palm striking, really, really trying to disorient her. He's being a gentleman. He's being fair with this whole thing.
A gentleman.
And he's keeping this right on the mat. You got to respect
a
guy like Jamie Senegal.
Jamie Senegal has been anything but a gentleman in this stunt fight.
Jamie Senegal trying to help her up. She obviously slips on that canvas again.
He was a gentleman. He would
People
not have
People do not
gone
give Jamie Senegal the
fight.
Credit for being the conscientious and respectful young man that he is.
What stunt
I
fight are you
see
watching,
it every
Paul?
Time I come up here. Another punch to the face of Jamie Senegal. I guess she's jealous that he looks better. She doesn't have to try to ugly him up.
She's far from jealous. Oh,
vicious
goodness.
Neck breaker. Why is everyone getting their necks hurt tonight? I think they should stop this match right now. Jamie Senegal is the winner. She cannot get up after something like that.
I think Maria Manic has enough fuel to go through in this stunt fight.
I feel like she's pushing Jamie to go to places he doesn't want to go. I don't think Jamie Senegal likes being this vicious.
And he misses with that moonsault. Lands on his feet, but here comes Maria. Oh, and Maria Manic.
Using the hair to pull Jamie Senegal down.
Up.
I'm just wondering why we can't see a fair fight out of this young lady from California.
We've seen nothing but fair.
I've seen punches. I've seen hair pulling. I've seen a fast count from the referee.
Paul,
what I'm saying the whole night, Jamie's got the entire deck stacked against him tonight. How's he going to pull out a win here?
Obviously, we're all on a different page here. Oh, but here comes Jamie. Oh, my goodness.
Jamie with a devastating front face smash.
Oh, this is a unique
Jamie
hole.
With a leg lock right now. This could be it right now. Middle of the ring, nowhere for her to go. Look at
Will
Jamie.
Will Maria Manic hang tough? Oh, but she got out of it.
I think Jamie might have tweaked his knee right there. I think the referee should check on Jamie to see if he's okay. I think he might have hurt his knee right there.
Here comes Maria.
Maria Manic digging her nails right into Jamie's back to get him down.
She is not. Oh, and a submission hold.
And a chokehold. How is a chokehold legal in a stunt fight? How is choking a man out? Why are you ringing
Ladies
the bell?
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by tap out.
This is supposed
Maria
to be a stunt fight. 1, 2, 3.
Manic.
And do we really allow submissions in the Sanctuary Stunt Studio, do we?
And there is your winner, Maria Manic, Paul.
Maria Manic, all the way from California to the Sanctuary, all the way from California to Hazleton.
She won this fair and square.
To cheat to beat Jamie Senegal. How it's legal to choke a man out in a stunt fight, I have no idea, but apparently we're letting people from out of state and out of the area get away with whatever they want.
I believe she calls that the Manic Depressant.
I'd be depressed too if I just got robbed the way he was.
Put up a good fight here.
I think the referee should restart the match or give the win back to Jamie Senegal. That was
I beg
blatant
to
cheating.
Maria Manic did an excellent job here tonight, and Jamie Senegal is a sore loser.
I think Jamie Senegal definitely put up. The referee wants to let anyone do what they want. Why do we even need a
complain once because I knew I could beat you. I'm not scared of you.
You know that you can beat me. I guarantee you, next time, you're not gonna beat me.
Is that a challenge?
That's a threat.
You know what, Jamie? You're on.
Things are more than this bullshit. Fuck it up. Knock it off.